Hi, my name is Jennifer Cocohoba. I'm a Health Sciences Associate Clinical Professor in the Department of Clinical Phamacy here at the UCSF School of Pharmacy, and I am an HIV clinical pharmacist. I did my pre-pharmacy requirements at the University of California, Los Angeles, go Bruins, and then did my School of Pharmacy requirements here at UCSF. During my fourth year clinical rotations, there was one patient in particular that really kind of made me realize the importance of having good HIV pharmacy care. And this was a young 25-year-old woman. She didn't realize that she was actually HIV infected and was suffering from a very bad opportunistic infection called PCP pneumonia. So when she rolled into San Francisco General Hospital, needless to say, she was very ill. She needed a chest tube. They were giving her very high dose, heavy antibiotics, and she was essentially miserable. And she was just as tough as they come, really just kind of trying to control her emotions and control herself around her confusion around the disease, her anxieties around her treatment. And one day I also realized that she was in the hospital and it was her birthday. So we had gone down to the gift store and gotten her some small token, probably a stuffed animal or something, and presented it to her as a tiny little birthday present to try to make her hospital stay a little bit easier or better. So this very stoic young lady, chest tube hanging out of her side, actually stood up from her bed and hugged every single team member that was on the HIV consult team. And I think it also struck me that she was a young woman of color, not much older than myself, and that had either of our choices been different, she could have been me and I could have been her. At the UCSF Women's HIV program, headed by Dr. Eddie Mochtinger, I run a treatment adherence program. Adhering to HIV antiretroviral therapy is very important to keeping an HIV-positive person healthy because antiretrovirals really strengthen the immune system against opportunistic infections and other illnesses that can cause morbidity and mortality. However, even though antiretrovirals, it seems like an easy question that you should just take your pills, taking antiretrovirals is often laden with more social implications than taking, say, a medication for hypertension or for diabetes. One of the main reasons that it's most difficult to adhere to HIV medicines is oftentimes our patients come and are told that they need to start taking antiretroviral therapy, yet they don't feel sick. So it's sometimes hard to find a reason to take a medication when you don't feel sick and you know the medicines are going to give you side effects. Nausea, diarrhea, fuzzy thinking, and these can get in the way of having a normal everyday life for some patients. So there are a lot of hesitation amongst the HIV positive community or people living with HIV AIDS around taking HIV medications, and part of my job is to help them learn a little bit more about antiretrovirals so they can make an informed decision on whether or not they're going to take them, when they're going to take them, and which kind they're going to take. One of my favorite roles in the treatment adherence program is simply to be a source of support when someone has made the big decision to start their antiretrovirals, to really be there for them, to listen to them about their side effects, to help facilitate their meetings with their doctors, and even to help them choose a new set of antiretrovirals when the first one or the second one, or maybe even the third one, hasn't worked well for them. My interest in HIV antiretroviral adherence has also grown into a research program. Because adherence is so complex, finding interventions to help people adhere to their medicines better is also something that we don't have the magic answer to. If we could somehow get people to take their medications on a more regular basis, the hope would be that people would be a lot healthier. And this includes people with HIV as well as people with other diseases. So my research focuses on a specific niche, which is how community pharmacists, the people that patients with chronic disease often see most frequently every month to pick up their antiretroviral refill or their other medication refill, how community pharmacists can help get their patients to take their medications better. The integration of pharmacists into the care of HIV-positive patients really showcases the expertise of pharmacists. The current roles that HIV pharmacists play with the patients and with their providers include things like providing drug information to the patients, helping patients decipher clinical trials about new medicines or even participate in clinical trials for new HIV medicines. They help providers and patients unravel complex drug interactions, provide adherence counseling, and do some simple things such as providing adherence reminder devices or packaging medicines and medisets just to help patients take their medicines better. And I think the role for HIV pharmacists is constantly expanding into areas we can't even think of right now. So the HIV pharmacist really displays pharmacists practicing at the highest level of their license to make sure that there is safe and effective use of HIV medicines for patients, and really that pharmacists on the HIV team, this serves as a great model for interdisciplinary care for pharmacists in other disease states and other healthcare settings.